I was thinking about the first time I was given 2 frozen vials of embryonic stem cells. Each vial cost $5,000. And my boss said, now you grow them. That was 10 years ago. And now look at my lab. We grow the cells routinely. For me, it's such a good thing to see how the science has progressed in this field.
I'm Amy Adams with California Stem Cell Agency. We asked you to submit questions about Parkinson's disease and stem cell research through our blog, Facebook, and Twitter. Today we're at the Buck Institute for Research on Aging, where Dr. Xianmin Zeng is going to answer those questions and also talk about her own Parkinson's disease research. Let's go in. Can you start by telling us a little bit about Parkinson's disease, what it is, and what the symptoms are?
Parkinson's disease is a neurodegenerative disorder which leads to progressive deterioration of motor function. And the cause is the loss of dopamine-producing nerve cells in part of the midbrain called substantia nigra. The primary symptom for Parkinson's disease is tremor, slowness in movement, impaired balance, and stiffness.
It was 10 years ago when you first started working with embryonic stem cells and Parkinson's disease.
Yes.
Now you're getting close to clinical trials. It is a long, slow path to get into people. What keeps you motivated?
I would say to keep me motivated is my goal is to make a difference. My hope is that what I'm working now today will someday benefit the patient. And at this moment, we have designed an embryonic stem cell line, which we know can be used for clinic purpose. And we have generated 2 lots of dopaminergic neurons suitable for direct transplantation into the brain to hope those cells will replace the lost cells and function in the brain. So we are now in a position to go to the FDA to file for a phase 1 clinic trial in the next 2 years. That's my estimation. So in hoping that we would be able to run a clinic trial in the next 3 to 5 years.
Why do we need a cure for the disease?
Because it's a terrible disease and there are about 1 million Americans suffer the disease. And with the aging population now, the number is expected to increase. And about 40% of the people affected by Parkinson's disease are under the age of 60. So there is a clear impact of society in terms of losing productivity.
One of the people who wrote in and asked us a question said, that the person's grandfather had Parkinson's disease, so what is the likelihood that I will also get it?
Parkinson's disease, first of all, is a disease described as a sporadic disease, which means actually you don't know the cause. 85% of the Parkinson's disease case are sporadic. So the chance that one person's grandfather has the disease, it may increase the person's chance of having the disease, but the keep in mind that the disease is more sporadic.
So you began working with embryonic stem cells right at the very beginning. And then since that time, people have learned how to reprogram adult cells, like skin cells, into an embryonic-like state. So they are more or less equivalent to embryonic stem cells, and these are the iPS cells that we hear about a lot. And you're now working with embryonic cells and iPS cells. Why do you work with both cell types?
Because iPS cells provided additional cell source for producing the right type of dopaminergic neurons, also because you now have a cell source coming from both normal and patient subjects, and you can use the cells to test different drugs to be better predict the potential clinic benefit.
So a person wrote in asking about the different types of stem cells. The person asked, what types of stem cells are best suited for treating Parkinson's disease?
I think this is a question nobody can now provide an answer. So, and that's why people need to work with different type of the stem cells in order to find out exactly this question, what type of the stem cells is the best. So that's why I'm working on both EA cells and iPS cells. There are a lot of people working in the field, and with the funding, with the right timing and the right training, we're ready to make new discoveries.